another 125 million spent on the second quarter of 2023, and another 125 million spent on the third quarter of 2023. This is a total, if I am correct, Attorney Camora, 500 million. Do you confirm?
That is correct, Madam.
Thank you. I wish to go back to my question during the last hearing, Attorney. I ask you, paano po ba natin i-distinguish ang confidential fund from regular fund? This time, I want a more comprehensive answer, and please try to laymanize it because I want this to be understood by the Filipino people. As a matter of fact, I am raising this question so the Filipino people will understand ano po ang pagkakaiba ng confidential fund from regular fund. Let us discuss first about the purpose.
Yes, Mr. Chair. Ang purpose po ng confidential and intelligence funds are for confidential and or intelligence activities. While yung sa regular funds po, it is for the attainment of programs, activities, and projects other than confidential fund and or intelligence activities. Ito po yung regular na perang ginagamit ng mga government agencies.
And if you will agree with me, Attorney, if I would say that when we speak of confidential fund, it has something to do with the national security, peace and order, surveillance activities. Am I correct?
That is correct po, Madam Chair.
And when we speak of regular funds, any other funds except something which has to do about security, peace and order?
Yes po, Mr. Chair.
Thank you. Now let's go to the procurement. Ano po ang pagkakaiba ng confidential fund from regular fund in terms of procurement?
Mr. Chair, in terms of procurement, the regular funds must follow the laws on procurement, which is now the RA 9184 as amended po. As to confidential and intelligence funds, to avoid compromising the confidential matters, it usually does not undergo procurement.
And do you agree that we have this joint circular which regulate the utilization of confidential fund?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Can you share with us what is that joint circular?
It is the joint circular issued by the Commission on Audit, the Department of Budget and Management, the Department of the Interior and Local Government, the Governance Commission for GOCCs, and the Department of National Defense.
Kanina, Attorney, you mentioned about Republic Act Number 9184. This is the procurement law as amended, tama?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
And you would agree with me if I would say, under the procurement law, before you proceed to procurement, there has to be a posting.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
There has to be an invitation to bid.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
There has to be a pre-qualifying process for the bidders.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
There has to be a bidding.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
There has to be a post-qualifying.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
And all of this will happen before we issue the notice to proceed.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
And if I may add, we also require the parties to execute a contract. Am I correct?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
And all these formalities are not present when we speak about confidential fund, correct?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
That is for the reason that we wish to protect concerns, matters concerning national security, peace and order, and surveillance. Tama yes. Po ba?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Okay. Now we proceed to number 3, about liquidation. Ano pong pagkakaiba ng confidential fund from regular fund?
Liquidation po for confidential intelligence funds is provided under the Joint Circular 2015-01. For regular funds, it is COA Circular number 97-002.
Can we laymanize it, Attorney Camora? Kapag po ba tayo'y magliliquidate ng confidential fund, anong dokumento ang nire-require natin from the agency?
The requirements are all indicated po sa, na-mention po kanina, 4.8 of the joint circular.
In substance, would you agree with me that what we are requiring, if it is a confidential fund, one is financial plan, is that correct?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Two is the accomplishment report, is that correct?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
And three is the certification of the head of the agency, is that correct?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Whereas when we speak about the liquidation of regular fund, what requirements do we ask from the agency?
These are all under 97-002.
I understand. If I would say that under the regular fund, you are requiring the MOA or the contract, am I correct? I understand that there is a long list of documents, but I'm trying to emphasize only the substantial documents which should not be absent in the compliance of liquidation requirements.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
There has to be a MOA or a contract if it is a regular fund. Second, there has to be a receipt.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
There has to be an invoice.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Thank you. May I request the Secretariat to please flash the first slide. This slide summarizes the distinction between confidential fund and regular fund. In confidential fund, we have the Joint Circular 01, which regulates the same. For regular fund, we have the procurement law, otherwise known as RA 9184, as amended. As to purpose, confidential fund is for the purpose of peace and order and surveillance activities to promote national interest. Regular fund or other purposes other than those mentioned in the confidential fund. For procurement, there has to be posting and bidding, requirements which are not necessary for confidential fund. And for liquidation, in confidential fund, it is enough that there is a financial plan, an accomplishment report, and a certification of the head of agency. Whereas in regular fund, there has to be a receipt, an invoice, a copy of the MOA, a copy of the contract. Do you agree, Attorney?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Okay. I will cite some illustration for the better understanding of the Filipino people. I will be using confidential fund. Ang bibilhin ko, supplies of materials and equipments. Kailangan ko po bang mag-post at mag-bid?
No, Mr. Chair.
Kailangan po ba na ang maging supplier nito is the lowest bidder?
No, Mr. Chair.
No. But if I will be using a regular fund, I will be purchasing supplies of materials and equipment. Of course, I need to go through the process of posting and bidding, and then I need to choose the lowest bidder. Tama po ba?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
And then, Attorney, I will be renting a safe house for surveillance activities. So this is a confidential fund.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Kailangan ko po bang mag-posting at mag-bidding?
No, Mr. Chair.
No. Diretso na sa rental ng safe house for surveillance, correct?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Do I still have to evaluate, invite, to be able to choose the lowest cost of rental for the surveillance?
No need, Mr. Chair.
No need, because this is a confidential fund. I will be buying a car for surveillance activities. Kailangan ko po bang mag-posting and bidding?
No, Mr. Chair.
Do I need to choose the lowest bidder?
No, Mr. Chair.
But if I will be using a regular fund, I need to go through the process of posting, bidding, and come up with the lowest bidder. Is that correct?
That is correct, Mr. Chair.
If I will be procuring an equipment for surveillance activities, kailangan po ba ang posting at bidding?
No, Mr. Chair.
No? Do I need to choose the lowest bidder?
No, Mr. Chair.
But if I will be utilizing a regular fund, these requirements are all necessary. Tama po ba?
Tama po, Mr. Chair.
Thank you. Now we proceed to confidential fund. I remember during the last hearing, tinanong po ito ni Honorable Marcoleta. He was saying that the other agencies and even the other LGUs have confidential fund as well. Tama po, Attorney?
Tama po, Mr. Chair.
You remember that?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
He made a manifestation that even the other agencies of the government and the LGUs have confidential fund. And I wish to share the second slide to our committee. That is the basis of the confidential fund of the LGU. And tantamount to saying that it is true that even the LGUs have confidential fund. This is DILG Memorandum Circular 2022-118 and the JMC 2015-01. Tama po ba ito, Attorney Camora?
Tama po, Madam, Mr. Chair.
And you will agree with me also that under Section 16 of the Local Government Code, kasama po sa mandate ng LGU, is to promote and maintain peace and order. I think the lawyers will agree. The lawyers from the DILG. I understand you're from COA.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
So let me share this information that under Section 16 of the Local Government Code, bahagi po ng mandate ng LGUs, local government unit, is to promote and maintain peace and order. And this justifies kung bakit mayroong confidential fund ang mga LGUs. Tama po ba, Attorney?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Now let's go to the mandate of the OVP. Kasama po ba sa mandato ng OVP ang promotion ng peace and order, conduct of surveillance activity, and national security?
May I ask po yung OVP team, mas knowledgeable po sila sa mandates.
OVP team, please. You are from COA also.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
But
may I allow to speak na po? May I allow to speak na po?
Go ahead.
Can you please enlighten us? What office are you representing? Why Attorney Camora refer you as the OVP team? Because I understand you're also from COA.
I'm the audit team leader of the Office of the Vice President for the audit of the regular funds.
Audit team leader of the OVP with respect to regular funds. But I'm talking about confidential funds.
Yes, Madam. Mr.
Do you think you are in the proper position to answer this question? This is about confidential funds.
But the question is all about the mandate of the OVP.
All right. What is the mandate of the OVP?
Based on the notes to a financial statement of the AR, annual audit report, the OVP, as the second highest office in the land committed to the service of the nation, OVP performs executive, ceremonial, and advocacy functions, collaborating with stakeholders and organizations in both public and private sectors to develop and promote programs that uplift the lives of the Filipino people. That's the mandate of the OVP.
Does it in any way mention about the peace and order, surveillance activity, and national security?
Based on what I've said,
the question is answerable only by yes or no.
No po.
It does not.
Yes, Madam.
So you confirm that matters concerning peace and order, national security and surveillance is not part of the mandate of the OVP. Do you confirm that?
Mr. Chair, yes po, based on the mandate provided.
Yes. And why do you think the OVP was given confidential fund, considering that it is not part of the mandate to promote peace and order?
I think I'm not the right person to answer the question because I think it may cause to the Department of Budget and Management because they are the one who provided the confidential fund in 2022.
I understand. But let me state for the record that nowhere in the law, not even in the Constitution, provide that the OVP has the mandate of promoting and maintaining peace and order, conducting surveillance activity, and even matters concerning national security. That is for the record, Mr. Chair.